After enduring the 400 miles of teeth-chattering bumps at Kentucky Speedway, the end result for both of our teams was almost as rough as the racetrack itself. Both of our drivers struggled all night in the turns with loose entry and tight exit. Which brings us into our first question from Nick Batiga. He wanted to know what we do to lower the car and raise it up to drop the splitter close to the ground and account for bumpy racetracks such as Kentucky. Well, what we do is we take rounds in and out of these springs in the front, rounds out to lower the car and rounds in to raise it up. Another option for us is to add packers to these shocks. By adding these packers, it doesn't allow the shock to compress as far, which brings the nose of the car up. Air pressure is also another adjustment. The more pressure in the tires, the higher the front end actually raises up. So this is the splitter that came off the 55 this weekend at Kentucky. And you can see all the wear that the track caused on it. And those sparks that you saw flying was actually from the button head bolts that hold this splitter onto the bottom of the front bumper. When that bumper hits and this splitter grinds against the ground, these bolt heads ultimately end up sparking and grinding off. Betty wrote us in on Twitter with the question, do the MWR drivers use carbon fiber or aluminum seats? As you can see, this is a carbon fiber seat right here with steel mounting brackets that hold it in place inside the car. And what makes these seats custom are these foam inserts that are custom molded around the driver's body, not only for their comfort, but so that they're locked into their seats and protected to be able to walk away from some of the horrific crashes that you see in our sport. Jeff Martin asks, how come we can race in the rain at road courses and not at ovals? And what preparation goes into the car when these events take place? Well, Jeff, in the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series, we don't race in the rain at any track. But in the Nationwide Series, they do, only at road courses. This is because with these slick tires that you have on an oval track, just would not be conducive to racing. They'd slide up into the wall on every single turn. But the preparation that goes into it during these times, if it starts raining during the event, typically NASCAR will red flag the race and give the teams a 10-minute window on pit road to make the changes to the cars. So the changes include adding rain tires to the cars so that it actually disperse the water and give the car grip onto the road surface. The next thing that we have to do is install a windshield wiper and a brake light into the back window. Linda Bell was curious as to fuel consumption with these race cars at idle or cutting the engine off. The reason why you see these drivers cutting the engine off during fuel mileage races is that just 3 seconds at these engines at idle uses just as much fuel as refiring them up. So when they're under caution laps that take a minute plus to coast around large tracks, they'll actually cut the car off 5, 6, maybe even 7 times. Now these drivers communicate this back to our crew chiefs so that our engineers can determine just how much fuel that they saved. In other instances, when we're not trying to conserve fuel, the way that we judge it is 2 caution laps burn just as much fuel as 1 lap under green. As always, thank you for your questions, and please keep them coming this Saturday as we return to Daytona International Speedway to start off the second half of the year. And keep your eye on the number 55 Aaron's Dream Machine, because it'll be sporting a special paint scheme never before run here at MWR.